Hi and welcome to Pendragon Woodcraft. The plan today is to turn this sycamore blank into a platter along the lines of this. This has a carved Celtic ring around the edge and a pyrography picture of two boxing hares in the middle. The image and the outer ring will be different, but it will be a similar design to this. This I actually did in beech a few months ago, and I'm now going to try it in sycamore. So if you fancy watching that, stick around and let's get on with it. The first thing I need to do is to mount this blank onto the lathe with a screw chuck. I'm bringing up the tailstock for added support because this is quite a big blank actually on the screw chuck. Should be fine, but just to be on the safe side. I'm using a 3/8 bowl gouge just to true up the edge of the blank here. Still using the 3/8 bowl gouge, I'm now tidying up the face with pop cuts. I'm marking for the tenon. There's a 56mm tenon to fit the sea jaws on the Exminster chuck. I'm using a 3mm parting tool to the depth of about 4mm to actually form the tenon. Back to the 3/8 bowl gouge, now pull cuts to shape the outside of the bowl. Switching now to a series of push cuts, again with the 3/8 bowl gouge, just to finish off the outside before I actually use a scraper on it.
using a negative rake scraper now just to finish off the outside of the bowl. Using the bowl sander now, going through the grits, starting with 120, then it's 240, 320 and 400 to finish off. Applying cellular sanding sealer. I'm using an abrasive paste wax now just to polish this up to about 1000 grit. Mounting on the sea jaws, ready to clean off this face again. I only actually need about the first two and a half inches perfectly flat to actually put the Celtic motif on. Mm. That's a 32mm skew chisel. I'm actually using it just as a scraper to get that edge flat there. I'm applying cellulose sanding sealer now, just around the section where the Celtic motif will actually be. Just lining up the Celtic design. I should be using carbon paper under this, and it wasn't a great idea. I should have tried to get some artist graphite paper, which is much better. Basically, the carbon paper is difficult to rub out, as I found out later. I'm actually using an 8mm V-tool here to cut the edges out on the Celtic design. This is actually speeded up 4 times now, in common with most of the other repetitive bits. Here's a two or three stills now, just to show you from different angles the finished carving. Just marking the internal rim now. I'm using a parting tool here, basically to cut a little groove, just so that if the bowl gouge just happened to skid, there's a safety wall basically, so it won't ruin my Celtic design. I shall only be doing a fairly shallow centre to this bowl. It needs to be flat for the pyrography, so I'm using the skew chisel again just to flatten it out. It's probably about 3/4 inch deep, or 19mm. The centre needs to be fairly shallow because of using the pyrography tool. It becomes a bit difficult if it's too deep. Just finishing off the edge of the rim there with the negative rake scraper. Just sanding through the grits now to 400. I shan't be putting any sanding sealer on it at this point because you're not supposed to use pyrography tools actually on any sort of treated surface, because of the risk of fumes off it. That's just purely a tack cloth just to get off any excess dust. As I mentioned earlier, I wasn't happy with carbon paper, so I've actually put a soft graphite actually on the back of this, and I'll be using just a point stylus to actually transfer the image onto the plate now. Just checking to make sure that everything's transferred. My pyrography machine is actually a Peter Child pyrographer, and the pen is using a spoon nib, which is great for shading, which is what I need on this actual design. I'm just outlining the main design at the moment. This is a still shot of the finished pyrography. Now I can apply the cellulose sanding sealer and finish this off. I'll be using some chestnut wood wax 22 just to finish off my final polish. The last job is just turning off that tenon now and finishing off the actual base of the bowl.
And here we go, there's the finished article. I'm rather pleased with the way it's turned out. Obviously the video time doesn't equate to the amount of time I've actually spent doing this. Pyrography took a couple of hours, the carving probably took a couple of hours, and the turning probably took an hour. So you're talking between 5 and 6 hours total to actually produce this. So if you actually like what you see, please consider subscribing to my channel, and I'll bring some more content very soon.